Hello and good day to all the horror fans out there. I was in the mood to end my night with an 80s American slasher film, and my choice of film ended up being one of the most boring, yet fascinating slashers I've seen in quite some time. I am Torstein from CinemaTerror, and please bear with me while I try to wrap my brain around the 1982 Death Screams. Death Screams, or its alternative title, House of Death, is filmed in North Carolina and takes place in a small quiet town. The end of summer is quickly approaching, and the young teens of the town is planning a final night of fun before they all go their separate ways to study for the next year. Their big day consists of drinking and pot smoking at a carnival, before heading out into the woods for both a campfire and to tell scary stories at a local cemetery. That all sounds fun and great. But their night takes a darker turn when a serial killer comes after them, lusting after hearing their death screams.
Maniacs, lick hands.
Before I get into the review, I just want to warn you that I will be doing spoilers here, as there is no way else to talk about death screams. Like I said in the beginning, this is an oddball of a slasher film that has an absurd structure to it. Usually in a slasher, you would try to set up the young adults, spread some murders out, and then have a final confrontation between a leading character and a killer that we by that point should have gotten the backstory of. In Death Screams, all of that is thrown out of the window. Story structure is for suckers, I guess. After Death Screams starts out with a typical kill scene of a young couple getting it on in a car, the movie tries to present us with our main characters, the young teenagers played by actors in the late 20s. Even if you spend the majority of the running time hanging out with them, it was still hard for me to separate them, as they were all pretty much the same. A few of them might have some special character traits, like the comic relief guy and the promiscuous girl, but the rest were indistinguishable. It doesn't help that the movie keeps introducing more and more characters, giving them plenty of screen time without going anywhere with them. Some simply just disappear and add nothing to the overall story. I could buy into that some of them were set up as red herrings, but others were obviously not, and had less than none involvement with the gruesome stuff that eventually will happen. And by eventually, I mean the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, Mama, got you covered, me and you! Yeah! Damn!
There are two different women that could have been the final girl, someone that we could be emotionally invested in. The first is Kathy, played by Andrea Savio, actually looking the age of her role, and she was apparently only 16 years old at the time of filming. She's your typical good girl and seemed like an appropriate choice for a final girl, but it turns out she does not get any special attention the more the movie moves along. The other one is Lily, played by Susan Kriger. Lily is beautiful but also very shy. She is kind and seemed like a natural choice for a final girl. Kriger had a start in the adult movie industry before becoming a Playboy playmate in 1977. She also had a few parts in other more sexually oriented comedies like h.o.t.s and The Happy Hooker Goes Hollywood before retiring after a performance in Death Screams. I guess the experience might not have been what she wanted, and it is easy to see why, as there is just as little done with her character as with anyone else. The killer is a whole topic in itself. I do realize that I might have missed something, but who the hell was this guy? When he showed himself at the final part, I had absolutely no idea who he was and what his motives were. How do you have a slasher movie where the killer is basically unknown to the viewer, even after the movie is done and over with? What happened there?
God, I thought you were gonna leave me, Walker.
The structure of the film is equally as baffling. We spend around 40 minutes with these guys in the carnival, before they finally get to a better slasher setting in the woods around a campfire. Things slowly start to happen, but we for some reason cannot settle on this setting, so they move over to a cemetery to tell ghost stories. Couldn't they just done that at the campfire? And when things go full horror, finally, they seek refuge at a house. I guess this is where the alternative title House of Death came from, even though they spend less than 10 minutes in it. And those 10 minutes are when the filmmakers finally remembered that they were making a horror film. To be fair, some of the murders are done pretty well. There are some blood and gore, and I've seen many other slashers of its time with a comparable budget the way worse. So it's not a total waste of time, but it does not make up for the first hour of absolutely nothing. You will also be amazed at the music choices in that screams. I have no idea, nor do I want to know, if this was music made directly for the film, or if it was scores that were made for other movies, most likely in other genres. It's at times very loud and it does not fit the film at all. It's just one of the several things that make Death Screams fascinating. It has a special regional horror type of charm that makes it kind of interesting to watch. It's boring as hell, but it still keeps you watching, as there is nothing else out there that are exactly like this. Death Screams is a forgotten slasher that only the most hardcore slasher film lovers will find any interest in. And if you are one and are considering picking it up, then beware that the UK VIPCO DVD is missing some of the good stuff. It is a film that I would usually not find interesting enough to do a review of, but there is something unexplainable about it that made it stick in my head for the next few days after watching it. So yeah, awfully boring, but yet fascinating. I guess that's the best way to express my feelings on Death Screams. And as a final score, I'm giving it a 2 out of 5. Has anyone else seen this one? Was it a dreadful experience for you, or did you also find it intriguing? And if so, why? And what are some of the forgotten 80s slashers that you feel more people need to check out? Looking at my past videos, I was surprised to see that I haven't really covered that many. So if you want that to change, then put me onto some cool ones that haven't been covered to death already. And leave a like, comment and all of that good stuff, as that does help me in choosing whatever I'm about to do a video on in the future. Hope you're doing well wherever in the world you are, have a great day, watch some cool horror movies, and come back for more videos on unknown gems, and not so much gems, here on CinemaTerror. Thank you!